We get cool new images of the steel starship on the moon and Mars. The VW ID.3 is now available for pre-order and has more than 10k reservations within 24 hours. The Shanghai Tesla Gigafactory 3 looks almost finished. These news and more after our cool new fancy intro.
So recent images from Boca Chica, Texas, where the first orbital prototype of Starship is being assembled, show how fast this beast is actually progressing. This here will be in fact the first prototype to be tested in space, in Earth orbit. At the same time, Elon shows new renderings of the steel-based Starship on the moon and on Mars. Look at how shiny this thing looks! That is so 50s retro-futuristic, that's just awesome. And apparently the prototype would be finished around June.
But keep in mind, this is Elon time we're talking here. You just take Elon time and add a few months to get the real time. Because as far as we know, as of today, only 4 of the 7 Raptor engines needed in Starship are even finished. But Elon Musk will give a public update on the progress of Starship and Super Heavy as soon as June 20th. We will follow this with high interest.
At the same time, Starhopper, the Starship test vehicle for in-atmosphere vertical landing and taking off tests, is well underway and could soon be seen flying untethered. A first short tether test was conducted already in April.
We were also shown a first picture of the Starlink satellites showing how they will be neatly stacked within the Falcon 9. For those of you who don't know, Starlink will be a gigantic system of almost 12,000 small satellites circling all around the globe in heights from 340 to 1,300 kilometers. The goal of Starlink is to enable high-speed broadband internet access all around the globe. Internet traffic load is still increasing and increasing, and land-based traffic will soon be overwhelmed by the whole amount of data. Starlink will basically decrease land-based traffic load by enabling high-speed satellite-based internet traffic. Now, the revenue created from selling these satellite-based high-speed internet services to providers will be used in large part to further fund Starship and Super Heavy development, which will then enable the Mars and Moon missions. And don't forget, we are talking about the first mega constellation of humanity here, which is basically like a Dyson swarm. Not yet around the Sun, but around the Earth, which is still very cool.
In EV-related news, the VW ID.3 camouflaged production version was recently revealed and is now ready for pre-order. And people seem to like it because on the first day, already 10,000 reservations had been counted. It will be offered in 3 range options with 3 battery options, 45, 58 and 77 kWh. Corresponding to 330, 420, and 550 kilometers of range on the WLTP cycle. So subtract around 20% for the real range. The car will be available starting from 2020. It's nice to see that finally other car makers are waking up. Thanks to Tesla, of course. Without Tesla, they would probably be still pumping out gas guzzlers. Anyway, we appreciate the efforts by other car makers to bring out real products now. Not only fancy-looking concept electric cars, which then never see the light of day.
In other news, Chinese customers are apparently quite happy with the efficiency of their Model 3. We also own a Model 3 Performance and have done quite a few efficiency tests, and we have to say we are also very, very pleased with the efficiency of this car. So apparently there are Model 3 owners in China who have totaled 140 watt-hours per kilometer over the entire lifetime of their Model 3s. We are impressed.
And then the Model 3 surprisingly gets back onto the US top 10 list for best-selling passenger cars. It was clear that the lower quarter one sales were just an intermediary dip. We assume that the quarter two and quarter three sales will be quite a lot higher again. We see that the Model 3 sold a brutal 10,050 units, a staggering 159% increase from April 1 year earlier. Does this look like Model 3's demand is vanishing? Dear CNBC, does it?
Also noteworthy is that recently an ARK Invest analyst came to the conclusion that the Tesla full self-driving neural net chip is putting Tesla around 4 years ahead of any other competition in the race to full self-driving cars. On Tesla's Autonomy Day on the 22nd of April, Tesla announced its plans for the ride-hailing Robotaxi service, where you can basically use your Tesla to drive around other people fully autonomously by the end of 2020 and earning you a nice profit in return. Elon Musk stated that your Tesla could earn you as much as $30,000 per year.
And it should be available by late 2020, depending on legislation. Interesting how fast things can change, right? Only 1 month earlier, we could read the following cool headline. Tesla ranks second to last in self-driving race by Navigant. GM and Waymo still on top.
Well, well, well. How much can change in 1 month? Interesting, isn't it? From being almost the last to being 4 years ahead of any competition in the matter of 1 month. And that, dear viewers, is why you shouldn't pay too much attention on negative news media headlines about Tesla. By the way, you can watch our video where we analyze why the news media might be so negative on Tesla all the time here.
We personally think that the FSD neural net processor revealed on Autonomy Day is a game changer. And Tesla will just be able to collect much more data than Waymo, Uber, or GM. Data is the most important asset. The neural net processor will have the data of the entire Tesla fleet of over 500,000 vehicles at its disposal, with over 1 billion miles driven, whereas the competitors have not even 1% of that figure.
Therefore, we think it's fair to say that Tesla will indeed lead the race to full self-driving. Indeed, it seems that late 2020 is quite a realistic time frame for the launch of the Tesla Robotaxi, even when taking into account Elon time. And now to the Gigafactory 3, which is currently being built in Shanghai. It is being built at an unprecedented speed. This is a side-by-side comparison of the building site in April on the left and 1 month later on the right. What the hell? If they would only build with 10% that speed in Germany. At the beginning of the year, there was basically nothing there, only a field, and by the end of the year, 1,000 to 2,000 cars per week will be produced in the Shanghai Gigafactory 3. This is mind-boggling.
And in this piece of news, Edmonds is amazed that the Model 3 got 5% more power via an over-the-air update. Well, we were also amazed. 5% more power for a car that already has a brutal amount of power. Now our Model 3 performance can accelerate in 3.2 seconds to 100. That's supercar type of performance for less than half the price. And the Model 3 keeps getting better and better. That's what we've been trying to tell people all the time. You buy a Tesla and the car keeps improving after you bought it, thanks to software updates. Edmonds did something that Tesla owners have already known for many years.
So let us know in the comment section if we have missed something, or if you have some constructive criticism, or if you think we are assholes. You can just also flame us in the comment section, because people like to do that on YouTube a lot, you know?
And if you're new to this channel, consider to subscribe, because we will keep making such videos to give you a nice summary of all interesting space and EV news.
And from time to time, we might pump out an unrelated video on some topic which we just find interesting and we just want to do because, you know, we just feel like sharing it with you.
So feel free to check all them out.
So see you next time.
Cheers.
Ciao.